Here's the deal. It's quite obvious that the next places where humans will go and even try to live for a while are the Moon and Mars. And most of us think about habitats there as some kind of small copies of Earth cities in domes on top and corridors in between them. But in fact, in reality, they can be very different. How exactly different, you may ask? Well, let's figure this out. As you probably know, there are several distinct problems with Moon and Mars. Ionizing radiation, which reaches the surface and has a very significant effect on all living things, massive temperature swings between night and day, which can reach more than 100 degrees, very thin atmosphere on Mars, and no atmosphere at all on the Moon, which obviously makes it really hard to breathe, surface dust, which is poisonous on Mars and electrostatically charged on the Moon, which makes it extremely sticky, and it is also sharp, which can make it a massive pain in all sorts of places, literally. And on top of that, there are also meteorites of all shapes and sizes, which have much easier time causing damage because of the lack of atmosphere. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. All that makes it really hard to design and maintain potential habitats or bases on Moon and Mars. But what if you take them from the surface and instead go under it? Some of the current projects, like the Moon Village by ESA, suggest first building domes and then putting regolith on top of it. And when it comes to Mars, maybe Elon Musk already thinks of digging tunnels there, otherwise why the hell he needs his boring company. But it's quite possible that there would be no digging required at all, as Mother Nature has already taken care of it all for us. We just need to go and use what's already there. You see, there are such things that are called lava tubes. They are naturally occurring tunnels that are created during volcanic activity. In simple terms, when there is a lava flow, it solidifies in an uneven way. First, the outer layers cool down, while the insides are still flowing. If the lava source is cut away somehow, all the insides flow away and there is a hollow tunnel left. Or even a whole tunnel system with branches and stuff. And these things are called lava tubes. You can find them here on Earth in abundance, but what's more important is that the same mechanisms work on Moon and Mars. Both of them had a lot of volcanic activity at some point in their history. Mars even has tallest volcans in the entire solar system, and the entire surface of the Moon is pretty much one huge layer of solidified lava. For now, no mission has ever looked inside the lava tubes on the Moon or Mars, but we know for sure that they exist. We have a lot of pictures that show the entrances to these tunnels. These are places where the roofs of the caves have collapsed and now parts of them are exposed to the surface. But the really cool thing is that they can be huge, because Moon and Mars have significantly lower gravity levels than we have here on Earth, it allows lava tubes there to grow hundreds of meters in diameter and tens of kilometers long. This means that you can fit not just a dome or a house inside, it means that you can literally put an entire modern city with skyscrapers and stuff inside one of those tubes and still have room to spare, which kind of makes places like that a natural place for a habitat. And you see, living in lava tubes solves multiple problems at once. A layer of soil above you protects you both from radiation and meteorites coming from space. Solidified lava on the walls can give you enough insulation to seal the part of the tunnel and maintain an atmosphere inside. Making a lava tube airtight and putting some sort of filter on the entrance protects you from dust. A cave also protects you from the day-night temperature swings. Also, both on Moon and Mars, there can be deposits of water ice under the surface, which can be used to get drinking water, fuel, oxygen, etc. All you have to do is get an energy source and put some kind of light bulb in the ceiling, and you have a living space on your hands. By the way, on Mars, places like lava tubes can be a really good place to search for life, as all the conditions we discussed can work well not only for potential visiting humans, but also for some local fauna that either lived there or maybe still does. You just need to remember one simple rule. Do not put your face over any wet eggs that you find. If there is one thing Hollywood should have taught us, it's that. But let's come back to being serious. I believe that we'll see a lot of missions that will try to explore lava tubes in the nearest future. first on the Moon, then on Mars. Of course, there are some obvious problems that need to be solved before that, like how to climb down there in a safe manner so you don't kill your robots instantly. Also, how to provide power. It's dark inside, so solar panels will not work, and other means of powering have their own issues. You also need to solve the communication problem, as thick walls can block a lot of signals and it will be hard to get any useful data back. And you also need to illuminate your way somehow, as it's obviously dark inside. Of course, we can learn a lot from speleologists who study caves here on Earth. They have all sorts of cool methods with lidars and other instruments that allow mapping the insides of the tunnels. The only thing left is to make their gear autonomous, strip the excess weight, pack it in the most compact way possible, and get it to the Moon somehow. Simple enough, right? But as the access to space is getting cheaper and the interest to the Moon is growing due to the Artemis program and potential new space race between the US and China, this means more and more missions will be flying to the Moon in the very nearest future, including small rovers and stuff. And some of them will most probably want to go and explore lava tubes that we know are there. There are even multiple existing projects in development. First, lava tubes will be visited by robots, and then possibly even by humans who will be going to the Moon rather soon. And if the caves appear to be what we think they are, it may well be a pretty good place to put your base in. So maybe humans will not only go to the Moon, but also inside it. Personally, I find it a bit ironic that first humans on Moon and Mars can literally be cave people. It's often considered that early humans on Earth have lived in caves, and even though it might not be true from a historic point of view, it can be rather poetic to have caves on other planets to possibly be a cradle for whole new civilizations in the future. Let me know what you think about it in the comment section. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like it, subscribe for more content like that, and support us on Patreon. But most importantly, stay curious, my friends.